Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. Yes, it is another Sophos appliance. This is the Sophos Generation 2 XGS 108. It is a desktop model. Not going to be a big technical overview. We'll show you a few things about it, show you what's in the box. Hopefully you'll find this useful. So in the box, you are going to start with a conformity guide, which you probably won't read, but it's there for you. You are going to get a get started guide. This has some useful information about the port configurations and everything, so is good and useful to hang on to. You will in the lid get a QR code, and it's really important this URL down here. This device is configured on the box, so you will need to know what to get to actually start the configuration of it. You are going to get a short USB USB to micro USB console cable. This is for out of bounds. So if you've managed to lock yourself out, or you need to make some emergency config and you can't get into the interface anymore, this should allow you to get there. You're going to get probably a 1.5 meter Ethernet cable. You are going to get some rubber desktop feet. Very exciting if you're going to put that on a desk and not put it in a rack on a tray. There are some aftermarket rack mount kits for this as well. Then this is useful just to get a little bit of air circulation. You are going to get a power lead. We're here in Australia, so here's our Australian end there, and we've got our IEC connector at this end. You are going to get the power pack. So we've got IEC on this end. We have a screw fit 12 volt on this end. You can have a second power supply, which I'll show you. This screws in really neatly so that it actually doesn't come out. If I get a chance, I might be able to show you that in the video. And I have the wireless model here. This is exactly the same as the wired, obviously just with wireless. So you're going to get two antennas for that as well. Then you're going to get the device itself. This and the model before it, so the XGS 88, have no fan inside them. So on the top, you get this big sticker. It does run warm. Please don't put things around it on it. It needs to vent through here. So as you can see, we've got ventilation holes on the front and the sides. On the bottom, we do have some screw hole cutouts here if you were to want to clip that to the wall. And then let's have a little look at the front. So starting over at this side, as you can see, we've got our console cable port, our micro USB. We've got a USB port, and then we've got our indicators here for our LAN and WAN being connected, all the different ports, and we can see even our hard drive light down there. And if you have two power supplies, you see both of them lit up. Then on the back, so what do we have? This is a very powerful little unit. So we first got our two antenna connectors here. We'll put the antennas on there so you can see at the moment. Then right over this side here, let me bring this into the screen, we've got our little power on switch. I often forget about that. It is very touch sensitive, so if the lights haven't come on, do remember to turn it on. You get your two power inputs. Let me just see if I can show you. So we can actually connect up our 12 volt in there. And once it's actually screwed on, let me do that. It is really solid in place. So obviously if you were to push that into the rack or even somewhere else that you had it, as you pull that unit forward, it's not going to come loose. What else do we have then? We have our console port, our standard one. So if you've got an RJ45 console cable, you can run that, yeah, and another USB. We have got an SFP, so that's 1 gigabit a second fiber port in here. Obviously you do need to get a transceiver for that. Then we have four 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet ports all the way. Well, we actually have six in total, but these are all 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet ports. So a really, really powerful unit. And obviously right there on the end, we have our reset. So let's just put those couple of antennas. So a couple of things for this. This does support 2.4 and 5 gigahertz wireless at the same time. So it's a 2x2. This is a different from the previous models that only supported one of them at a time. So you can run both frequencies at the same time. There we go. So let me just show you there so you can see that with the antennas on. And we have put this on a test bench. On the test bench, with all the security services turned on, including SSL inspection, we can get around about 540 megabits a second. So for a unit like this that's meant to be the entry level to your cybersecurity posture, this is an incredibly good firewall. And if you've got a connection less than 500 megabits a second, this really could be the firewall for you. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got more in-depth things on how to configure your Sophos in 30 minutes and secure your network. Plenty more tutorials, how-to guides, how to access the console, and all of those type of things, as well as unboxings on network firewall, wireless, and camera security. So head on over to our YouTube channel, subscribe, and stay up to date.